All right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I know it's been 2 days, I think, since I last broadcasted, but I'm ready now, ready to go. Had some things going on in real life, which is why I wasn't able to. Family in town and whatnot, and then tonight just getting back in. I actually referee football games as well, so I was out at a game. It ran a little bit longer than I expected. But I am back now to broadcast another game in the Falcons franchise. So we got week 11 coming up here, and we have to play against the Colts. Actually, I'm not even certain how well they're doing. But before I get to that, you see how we are doing in the NFC South. Of course, we're atop that. Saints have dropped another game. So we're sitting at 8-1. They're 6-4, and we're not worried about the Panthers or Bucks at this point of the season. As it stands right now, we need to get to 12 wins to guarantee playoffs for us out of this division. And, you know, of course, that's still subject to change based off of how things are, you know, played out and whatnot. So let's take a quick look right quick at the Colts. 4-5 on the year. Okay. Get a general idea. But like always, I can't underestimate any team. As y'all have seen, I do have a loss to a team that I did underestimate, and that still bites me. And one other thing, too, I'm going to go ahead and take care of real quick. Those two players that I was trying to re-sign, I did not offer them any new contracts yet. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. Also wanted to mention, I now have a Twitter page for this. And if you follow me on there, I try to post when I am going to broadcast, as well as when I post up new YouTube videos and everything like that, too. So same name, Shakira725 on Twitter. Or at Shakira725, however they want to do it on there. But, so feel free to follow me on there, and I'll try to make sure I keep you all up to date. So if you wanted to happen to catch a live broadcast, you can. So let's go ahead and offer this to Bartu. I don't want to offer too much more, but we'll see what he says. Still negotiating. He's probably rejected that one, too. And go ahead and offer Wurlow as well. Get that out the way. Neither one of them accepted right now. That's fine. We'll keep on going. Still rejected. They're going to be difficult, aren't they? All right, let's go. We're in the Georgia Dome for this game, too. Home field advantage. Should be able to take it to them. Oh, and I will be experimenting, not on this one, but on future broadcasts to see if I can get a better quality up on YouTube. I know it kind of varies between a few different things, and that's because I've been porting it directly from Twitch over to YouTube. So I might see experimenting with another way of trying to record everything and get that over there and see if that works better for a better quality. Because I know y'all want to see all of this in 1080p and 4K and whatever else it'll let me record up to and all of that stuff. So, but we are having a great season so far. Really hope the Falcons have a season like this in real life. That would be an amazing thing to have happen. So Devontae Freeman is still, 102 yards away from his season goal? We can make him get that, hopefully in this game.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two running backs will take the field today in hopes of leading their team to victory. It's Freeman's Falcons going up against Gore's Colts.
Yeah, that's a pretty good season.
And we'll go down to Jim Nantz and Phil Sims for this Week 11 matchup.
Oh, dang. Maybe it isn't. I thought we were having a good season until I saw Frank Gore's numbers.
It's the NFL on EA Sports. Week 11 here in the NFL as we join you from the Georgia Dome. Hello, friends, and welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. Jim Nantz and Phil Sims here on the scene getting set for kickoff. And Phil, it's all yours before we get the game started.
Well, Jim, let's start this way. The old cliche we hear all the time, let the game come to you. Hey, that might have been good 20 years ago, but not anymore. Now you got to go out there and take it. Which team is willing to take some chances to win this game today?
Okay,
that's the one that's going to win.
Pumped and excited, been waiting on this game, wanted to play it yesterday, glad to be able to get it in today.
The that team that sits atop the NFC South has the football on the tee, getting set now to kick it away and get this game started.
Oh, terrible.
We're
kick
away here. They're setting up the return. And the tackle.
All right, we made a stop. We didn't get hurt from that, luckily. That could have been a lot worse.
Luck's going to be at quarterback.
Oh yeah, Andrew Luck. 2,400 yards already. Wow. 15 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. This dude is playing very well so far, but that's to be expected from Andrew Luck. That is definitely to be expected from Andrew Luck. I don't even know if my pass rush will be able to get to him. And they got Andre Johnson and T.Y. Hilton, too. Ooh, Paul Werlow, let's go. He starts the game off right, getting a nice hit on him.
Colts offense. A lot of people thought coming into the year this would be one of the best rushing attacks in the league, but it's been very average to date.
Here we go, here we go. You know what, we're going to call it the same thing. That seemed to work pretty well. I'm not trying to press these guys on the outside because T.Y. Hilton and Andre Johnson both scare me. I know both of them can be deep threat players. Oh! Who was that? Solia? Solia gets the sack on Luck. That's what you call a coverage sack. Because we definitely didn't blitz. That was a four-man rush up front, and one of the four got there. Great play by the D-line. Paul Solia making us look good. Oh, and for those that might be new to watching me, this is on All Madden. I did not adjust any sliders. So this is All Madden.
Takes it from the gun.
Oh, good throw by Andrew Luck. Managed to find, is that Kobe Fleener? Yeah, managed to find Kobe Fleener right in the gap in the zone. Nothing I can say but great throw right there. That's the danger of playing that zone, boy. If you got a good quarterback that knows exactly where to put it, they can tear it up. But we're not going to let that deter us. We got to still play hard out here.
First down, following the long play.
Here we go, first and 10. Let's go, Falcons. Pickett! Got deflected by like three different Falcons after leaving their receiver's hand. But none of us could pick it up. Still, great play by the defense, though. Make sure that he didn't come down with it. We're out here doing big things. Got to continue to play hard. Second and 10.
Second down following that incompletion.
They got Kobe Fleener spread out in the slot.
Luck's got two tight ends on the field for this snap.
And he's going to running back is met at the line of scrimmage by like three different Falcons there. Third and 9 coming up. That was a tackle they credited to Justin Durant on that play. Third and 9. I'm a little bit nervous. I don't think I'm going to play that zone on this one. I think I'm gonna go man to man. I'm playing simple right now. Just trying to feel out Andrew Luck before I start sending some blitzes, you know. Oh, Pickett! Trufant had it in his hands and dropped it. But still, great play defensively. He was covering T.Y. Hilton, I think. And man, he made a great play playing right underneath the ball, being in position. Look at that. That would have been a nice interception had he got it, but it's all right. We'll take a pass deflection or whatever they call it on here.
Pat McAfee now ready to
Let's
punt.
Go. Fourth and 9. Pass defended. That's what they call it on here. That'll go into the end zone.
No return as this goes for a touchback.
All right, defense held him. That's what I like to see right there. We got a first down coming up.
He holds virtually every.
Let's see how Matt Ryan compares.
Single season and
1,800 yards, and I think Andrew Luck was at 2,500. So we're definitely behind him by about 700 yards. But again, we've had an up and down season. Matt Ryan throwing a lot of picks this season.
Lined up, two tight end set. It's the old counterplay.
Oh, Freeman hits a nice little juke, makes the corner miss on that play, gets an extra yard or two from it. That's what we want to see right there starting out. We want to make sure that we can move the ball on the ground, like to set up the pass. Oh, DeMarco left the running back by himself. If DeMarco had blocked that guy, that may have been a first down. Unfortunately, it wasn't. Now we got a third down and third and three. Here we go.
The Colts defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Freeman's going to take the handoff now.
Look at Freeman. Freeman breaking some tackles, finding the open space. That's what we need to see from Devontae Freeman right there. That is what we need to see right there. Beautiful run. Found the cutback lane. It opened up perfect for him. Hit a juke move. Got outside the four defenders, I think, that were there.
And
was just about gone. I think the safety from the other side of the field had to make that stop. Wonderful play right there. Wonderful play.
At the 31. The offense back to the line of scrimmage after going for more than 40 yards on the previous play.
Oh, and we have a drop by Toy Lolo. It was kind of a close play, though. If I waited a little longer, that could have probably been picked by the defender there. Bottom of the league for rushing yards per game. You know what? Not surprising. Our run game has been terrible so far. You know, we had two games, I think, where we had like 5 yards or less running this season.
Second down and 10.
And it's not from a lack of trying. There it is. Coleman was patient, waited for the blocks to set up, then hit the speed. And that was a beautiful run. Way to get that first down. The ground game is here today. For the team, 74 yards rushing, and we're still on the first drive of the game. Look at that block by DeMarco. This is what we wanted to see. See the team come alive right here. This is what we needed to see. Tevin Coleman still in the backfield. You know what? They overloaded that side. We're going to flip this, run to where the wide receivers are.
Here's the handoff, and they'll run.
Nowhere to go, unfortunately. They stuffed that one. They absolutely stuffed that one. Second and goal. 50 seconds left before the end of the first. Here we go. Jacob Tammy, touchdown. Touchdown. Right there.
First touchdown of the season.
It looked like they overloaded the right side. I don't know if that was zone coverage or they were sending a blitz, because I was just trying to get it off fast. But Jacob Tammy opened up right there across the middle, catching the pass just in front of Lowry. Great touchdown. And it gives us a lead here, about to be 7-0. There we go. 7-0. All right, Falcons, we just had a beautiful drive. Now we got to manage to make another stop on defense. We stopped them on the first drive, got to do it again.
The Colts are ready to return the kick.
Here we go. And we're off with another kickoff.
Hilton's got it on the return.
Oh, Hilton broke a tackle. Was that bar two? Man, he ran through bar two like he was nothing. Drop low bar two. All right, first and 10. We're still okay here, fellas. We are still okay. First and 10. 40 seconds to go before the end of the quarter.
get incorporated into the game.
Again, we've been going with very base defenses here in this game so far.
Let's see if they can keep it going. Hand off, out of the eye.
Not trying to get too fancy just yet.
Gain on the play of about six.
My concern is that if we start sending in a lot of fancy things against a quarterback like Luck, he'll be able to pick us apart.
Running backs in the NFL now, it's hard to bring them down. That time, nice job of breaking the tackle. Second and three after that last
I will actually, though, send a blitz on this one just to see what happens.
Andrew Luck under center.
Oh! Now, we sent the blitz and we couldn't get pressure on him. That's a testament to just how good that Colts offensive line is blocking us right there. Not a single pass rusher got off their block there. Alrighty.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade. Win from within.
The Colts will attempt to carry over that momentum.
Here we go. A new set, a new series. First down here for them. Let's see if we can make a play this time around. First and 10. Ball is at our 40-yard line.
Now it's time to back it up. Down the field.
Oh! T.Y. Hilton burned Trufant. Absolutely burned Trufant on that one. I don't know what happened. I don't know if True tripped up or something early on, but he was not able to keep up with T.Y. And that's partially my fault, too, since I was controlling the safety. I should have been back. But they did fake me out on the run, and I was sitting there looking run the whole time. So the Colts managed to tie it up pretty much here because I'm sure they'll make this field goal. Yep, Colts managed to tie the game up 7 apiece here. Early in the second quarter.
Got a tie game now. Getting set to kick it off. The score's 7-7. The Falcons.
They wouldn't make it easy on us. We got that one stop. We got to hope we can get another one. Or else this will be an interesting game.
Smith's going to test the coverage this time.
Able to move. All right. Antone Smith getting out to about the 23-yard line. Let's go ahead and continue with his run attack since it's been so successful. They done loaded up with a 5-2. No, that's a 4-3 over, I think. Or no, that's a 3-4, it looks like. Oh! Oh, no! That's not the kind of play that we need right there. Getting tackled in the backfield for a loss of 4 yards. The blocking was not set up well there. All right. So, with that being said, I think we're going to go to the air on this one. See if we can make up some of these yards here. Second and 14. Good throw, good catch. Matt Ryan throws back shoulder to Julio. Julio turns, adjusts, make that catch, get us third and two. That's exactly what we need right there. Third and two down. Third and two. Wow. I don't know where the down came from. Third and two. Let's go ahead and try to straight up the gut. See if we can get up there. Whoa. Looks like they're kind of overloading that side too, but we're going to stick with it. Nope. Oh, get across the line. We didn't get that, did we? Fourth and one. Ah, I thought he had it. I'm not going to go for this. It's still early in the game. Still very early in the game. Fourth and one. We're punting it away here. And a nice little stop right there. Nice little stop. Doesn't let him get too far.
The Colts offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they
here we go. First and 10. They got the ball.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for him. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players.
I don't know what is going on with my secondary, but they are getting beat. T.Y. Hilton has been making some moves and getting outside on us.
Oh, man, a quarterback.
quarterback. Let's go ahead and trust Hernandez with a little blitz here. And they're just so strong. See if maybe that'll mess him up. I'm not trying to press him. Concentration, and you never see him drop a pass. The Colts take it from the 43. Oh no, run play. I was not looking for the run. I was definitely looking for the pass right there. That was a great call by their offensive coordinator out there making a run play. Get the linebackers dropping back for pass, and there's an open gap that the running back took advantage of. All right, here we go. Second and three.
3.5 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Two tight ends on the field here. Three-step drop.
Oh, pick! Ishmael almost had the pick. Oh, that would have gone to the house. That would have gone to the house. Look at that. Step right in front of it. That is like the second or third pick we've dropped in this game here.
Failing to connect their third down.
Andrew Luck alone in the backfield. More than likely, this is a pass.
Midway second quarter. The reception by Moncrief.
Ooh.
Moncrief's tackled down.
So it looks like Dante Moncrief faked out Robert Alford on that play. Managed to make the catch, but he got lit up by, I don't know if that was Ishmael or Godfrey. I didn't see the number. That was Godfrey. Godfrey lit him up. Okay.
Really been stepping up so far.
The passing game is keeping them in the game. There's
my
no
defense has been bending a lot here. I can't afford to have them break.
Receivers and the quarterback, and these guys are taking advantage of it.
And now on first down, they'll go back to the air. Incomplete. The hit.
I think Andrew Luck took a shot on that play. I felt it.
As you watched the receiver trying to make that catch, he knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it.
It looked like Warlow could have almost caught that one, too, when he was trying to make the play on Andre Johnson. But, hey, Andre Johnson gets a rare drop. Maybe that's because the defense made him nervous or something. Maybe it's that horseshoe on the side of his helmet. I don't know. Either way, drop pass. Here we go. Second and 10.
Try over again on second down.
You know what? I'm going to go ahead and try to press him on this one. I haven't been pressing at all yet, so I don't know how we do on the press. I'm going to cheat to Andre Johnson's side, though, just in case. Frank Gore, we kind of kept him quiet today. Five rushes, 19 yards. We kept Frank Gore pretty quiet. He could definitely be doing a lot more on us. Here we go. Third down, third and 7. And 2-minute warning here.
And we've reached the 2-minute warning.
Third down, 7 yards to go again. We're going to go ahead and hop on Beasley here and see if we can make a play. Why didn't... Okay, I don't know why Southward... I would have thought Southward would have moved with his guy.
The Colts on their offensive play sheet, they don't have many plays for third and long situations, but that is a really
that was
nice
a jacked up situation.
The offense, the quarterback, they pick up the first down. That'll get you going.
Luck's completion percentage, 60% on the day. Scanning the field.
Picked. Picked. Let's go.
The ball's coming out to the 20.
Godfrey makes a huge play in the back of the end zone.
As we near halftime, the offense has the opportunity to
that's what we needed to see.
Into the break.
Well, I don't like their chances, and really both of these teams has been pretty sorry play so far here in the first half.
And we're within 2 minutes, so that means we got to make it down the field pretty quickly here if we want to score on them.
The Falcons got absolutely nothing out of their previous possession.
All right, first down.
Another three and out, I would have to think would be very
10 yards. Let's go.
Right now,
yeah, it's going to be demoralizing to the offense. But
Julio making a wonderful catch. We're trying to do the hurry up right here. They're going to play off of Julio again. We may throw it to him again.
First down at the 32.
Oh, he read it that time. He made a cut on the play before the ball was thrown. You know what? That was just a great play by Davis. I can't even say anything because he saw us do it, this play before. He knew what was coming, and he bit on the ball.
He's had the time to air that football out, and what we are seeing, the speed of this
offense. That was a bad decision by us, I guess.
They can get down the field behind the defense, and they are making big plays.
What a great job by the defense coming up with the
ball, giving themselves one more chance. We got to recover here.
Well, yeah, is it a great job? I don't know. The quarterback, oh, terrible decision. I know, good play by the defense getting that interception, but the play call, the decision by the quarterback, they were both bad.
Beasley unable to get off a play, I mean off the block, and they complete the pass too. First and goal. We're going to go ahead and send this blitz here. Let's see if we can make something happen here.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Andrew Luck in shotgun formation.
Oh! Andrew Luck takes a hard sack. Second and goal. They're taking their first timeout. Or second timeout, actually. Second timeout.
To the line at the 14. Playing press coverage to the outside. Second down and a long way to go.
Oh, what a throw and catch. Wow, Dante Moncrief making the low catch in the end zone for the touchdown, giving the Colts the lead over us. Hate to see that happen, but you know what? That was still a great play by them. I don't know if we could ask for better coverage from at Robert Alford in that one, because he was draped all over Moncrief. So that's unfortunate, but nothing we can do but continue to play hard out here. This game is far from over. Second quarter, we still got 51 seconds to go before half.
Everyone's lined up for this kickoff. Smith got it.
What kind of terrible blocking was that? Toy Lolo didn't even go forward.
White's ready to start this next possession. They're staring at a deficit, and he's not had a first half to remember.
Okay, here we go. First and 10, 48 seconds to go.
A lot of people to blame on the offensive side, and I'm going to start with the coaches. You just got to have a better plan on how to get your
wide receiver open. That pass was a little high right there. I think it was the right idea, but it was just a little too high. See if we can throw them off with this right here.
Dime package, second and 10. Freeman's out there to receive the screen pass. Breaks out of the tackle.
Freeman with the tough run. That was an amazing play right there. Did y'all see that? Wow, that was a good play. I did not expect all that to happen.
Offense getting set now following the timeout.
I'm glad it did, though. Got us on their side of the 50. Just inside the 50. We're going to see if we can make something happen through the air here again.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Matt Ryan from the shotgun.
Oh, no. Oh, no. That was a terrible.
Good job that time by the defense.
Terrible way to have that happen.
Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play.
Thought Roddy was going to be able to get up there and make a play. But, nope. Quite simply, that's it. Nope. It did not happen. Their defender was there, ready to make a stop, and he did. All right. I wouldn't be surprised if the Colts just try to run this one out here with 27 seconds left.
We didn't see it from their defense.
You know, we're going to continue to play hard out here, though.
And just do your job.
The Colts take it from the 23.
Ooh-wee. I'm so glad that, who is that? Jalen Collins was able to get off that block, because if he was not, that probably would have gone to the house. He was the last line of defense out there. And it was looking a little scary. That's all I got to say about that. It was definitely looking a little scary.
That leads us to second down.
We're going to stay on Claiborne here. See if we can get some pressure on this left side.
We'll take the snap from the gun.
Man. They are double teaming the crap out of my guys on the line. We are not able to generate pressure. And that was a great pass and catch by their guys.
Sometimes that doesn't matter. They're so big and they got long arms. They can still make the catch. Quarterbacks give them a chance.
All right, we'll try Beasley again then.
The Colts will take the snap from the 45.
Ooh, we lucked up. We lucked up. I'll take it, though.
We've reached the intermission. And soon we'll be sending you to Larry Ridley, who's going to break down all the first half highlights. As we send it,
I did not mean to skip it.
You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Oh, Anton Smith caught a little edge and was able to run pretty far. That's what we want to see right there. Nice kick return by Anton Smith.
Well, a lot of good things happened on both sides of the football this time. How about that return by the return
team? Look at that.
Good job.
Had to pull my best Lee Corso right there.
That guy running. They get the tackle from behind. They stop the touchdown.
All right. Here we go. New drive. New quarter. We can get it going right here.
Well, Jim, I'd say this.
They've held us pretty stagnant so far.
I just hate what they're trying to do on the offensive side. They're not putting their players in position to give them a chance.
That was okay. That was a good run. Not really anywhere else to go on that play. They had three defenders, and Freeman was by himself. So I'll take that. Five-yard gain is a great gain.
They love counter runs. They know when a defense has been over-pursuing, so they make that fake one way, and when they cut it back, there's usually a great running lane there.
Freeman getting up in there. Did he get the first?
He's now over 50.
Third and inches. You know what? We're going to pound this one right up the middle right here. Third and inches. Why not? Make them stop us.
Football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Falcons have it at the 39.
Look at that. Philip DeMarco, or Patrick DeMarco. I don't know why I keep saying Philip. Patrick DeMarco getting the first down, doing his thing for us. Hold on. For this play here, I want Tevin Coleman and I want that speed on this toss. We're going to head right around the edge with this one right here. First and 10. Here we go. Oh, Julio let go of his block. That was bad. If Julio held on to that block even another second longer, we probably were gone for a first down right there. But that's okay. Second and 9. Keep playing hard. Our run game has been effective against them. And like the saying goes, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And we're in for the touchdown. Let's go. Devontae Freeman getting us here to tie up the game. Devontae Freeman has had an impressive game today, y'all. Devontae Freeman has juked and jumped and trucked and did everything you ask a running back to do. He's run the ball. He's caught the ball. He's been looking great in this game. And honestly, he's one of the reasons why it is a tie game right now for us. He is one of the reasons why it is a tie game. He's been doing his thing. 14 up.
Scores 14 to 14. The Colts are ready to return the kick.
And a deep kick just inside the end zone here. They're going to take that out.
Running this one out.
Tough hit by Tammy. Was hoping for the ball to pop out, but it didn't. Still, great play, though, defensively. All right, first and 10. Playing out a base 4-3 here.
The Colts from the 22. Gore's hand.
Oh, no.
On his way.
Frank Gore found running room in that play and just made us pay for it, made me pay for it since I pulled the safety out of position. I thought that run was going to go to the outside, and he said, ha, he thought wrong to me. So Yeah, he made me pay big time. The 41. But you know what? That's okay. We're still all right here. First and 10 from our 41-yard line.
First down at the 41. Luck.
There we go. Paul Werlow meeting him in the middle. But that was Heron that time running the ball. Werlow met him in the middle and was not going to let him go anywhere. 4-3 over up in here.
Coming to the line at the 40-yard.
See if we can get some outside pressure on him.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. The Colts will take the snap from the 40.
Ooh! Big sack, Claiborne getting to Andrew Luck on the rollout. Awesome job right there by Clay. Third and 16. They're coming out in that, but I guarantee you they're going to be throwing the ball. I don't see why they wouldn't be.
Gore lined up as the single back.
Almost picked. Alford was in position, but he didn't make the play. Still, great job by him, though, to get a pass knocked down right there. Cut right up under the receiver. Fourth and 16, and I think they're just out of field goal range. Yep, fourth and 16, and they're punting the ball to us. That's out the back of the end zone. Ball placed at the 20. Here we go.
The Falcons offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession.
Well, you know what? With this steady run game, we got to keep trying. We got to keep going with it.
They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
Oh, no. Toy Lolo did not hold on to that block right there. They were able to get off the block and make a tackle in the backfield. Second and 12.
Look for a few yards. Take advantage of that.
See you running over here to Roddy's side. Maybe is a little bit better.
And here's the toss.
Oh!
Wide open.
Nice block by the fullback, lead blocker right there to spring the running back for a 23-yard run. Great play there. Great play. Let's go ahead and try the screen pass again since we haven't tried it in a little bit here.
They come back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play. Freeman's ready to run off the screen.
Oh, still great run. Way to get the first down after the catch. Matt Ryan hung in there, threw a tough pass. Had all those people in his face. Made him pay too.
Picked up some good yards.
Here we go.
To the 41-yard line.
First and 10.
First down and 10.
Oh, Matt Ryan takes the sack. I was trying to hit Roddy White on that underneath stop route. Unfortunately, it didn't work out there.
You get a defensive tackle that can get in the backfield and sack the quarterback. That is something special.
We're going to go ahead. Since we took a big sack, we're going to go ahead and throw a deep ball here. End of the third, so we'll throw it in the fourth quarter.
We're headed to the fourth. Thus far, defenses have taken center stage in this one. We'll be back after this. We're about to start the fourth quarter. We're all tied up, Phil.
All right, 14 a pop.
Continue to match one another here.
Yeah, it's been fun to watch this. It's been a fantastic
enter in the fourth quarter.
Here, today.
Here we go, second and 20. It's on them. That's that glitch I mentioned a couple videos back. The one that happens at least once a game where the defense gets a random encroachment call.
And now, after the penalty, it's second down and 15. The Colts go with the dime formation.
All right, second and 15.
The final quarter underway now.
Oh, no. Wow. McDonald comes up underneath for the pick. I could have sworn that we had that one, but they proved me. They proved me wrong.
But listen, there's nothing he can do about the offensive line. It's not been as sharp. And I'll tell you what, when an offensive line is not sharp, our quarterback's going to lose confidence.
There they go with that mess again. This time I need to make southward move. Crap.
Scans the field.
Pick him. Andrew Luck had all day, but that's because I didn't rush with Claiborne on that one. I tried to go a little too early. And if I end up not being able to get it on time, I tend to try to drop back if I can. Because there's no way I was going to make that sack. Although with as much time as he had, I probably could have made that sack.
The Falcons will come out in the dime. Second down and 10.
Oh, Worlow. Let's go. Worlow meeting Gore in the hole. Said, this is my spot. You aren't coming here. That's what I like to see from Paul Worlow. You know what? I like this little dime that we've been doing with it because of the fact that they hadn't been able to double team all my D linemen. Third and 11.
Third down and 11.
Oh no, T.Y. Hilton just made, I think that was Trufant covering him. Made Trufant look bad right there.
The Colts have been involved in a highly competitive game here today, and it's been their passing attack that has come through. Luck's really been locked in.
Alrighty.
Their passing game has.
We got to come up with an answer here.
Football game. That's why they're tied, and they got a
fourth quarter. Time is not our friend anymore.
First and 10. Gore.
Ooh, Durant meets Gore in the backfield on the cutback. That's what we needed right there. Second and 10, Justin Durant, two tackles on the day.
Set up now at the
36. Here we go.
Gore is in the backfield. And the give to Frank Gore.
I think they're trying to run a lot of this clock out since they feel they may already be in field goal range. That's what it's looking like, at least.
On the ground.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Good play. Jalen Collins getting in front of Andre Johnson and saying, no, sir, not in my house. That's what we need. Fourth down, 6 yards. More than likely, the Colts are going to kick the field goal here.
This will be a field goal attempt from 49 yards out.
And they made it. Made the long field goal. 49-yarder, I believe they mentioned it.
Position to win the game. The defense now will be rallying, trying to make a stop.
Okay, yeah, you know, the good thing is they got the lead. We're in the fourth quarter, but in the back of your mind, you have to think, wow, we really could have used seven.
Decent return. Decent return by Antoine Smith. Or Antoine Smith, I mean.
The Falcons offense back on the field trying to make.
All righty, let's see if we can get something going here.
The turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you may.
Man, they got on Freeman, but Freeman was able to outrun at least one guy before getting brought down.
The Falcons have stayed with the run game today, and it's been a big part of their game plan. Freeman,
let's see if we can get something else going. Second and 6. 2:50 left in the game.
It's arms, elbows, everything is moving, and he is one tough running back to tackle.
He's got nice catch by DeMarco.
They'll mark him at the 40.
At the 40? He caught that ball 3 yards further. That should be a first down. They must have claimed that he had ended up changing, and he must have been able to get control of himself for a brief second or something. I feel cheated on that one, y'all. I do. Felt like that one should have been stopped up there where he got it at the first down line.
Time is running out here in the fourth, and the defense is trying to preserve this win.
Ooh, Julio dropped it. We got to go for it, unfortunately. We have no choice but to go for it here.
Odds are on your side, and you go for it. That's what I think.
Here it is, fourth quarter. You're down. You're near midfield. Fourth and short. I think you've got a very good chance of getting this. I would go for it, but we'll see what the coach decides.
Who is that? Julio? Julio manages a tough catch. I don't know how he came up with that, because I could have sworn that they had blocked it down or something, but I'll take it.
2 minutes
left in the game, ladies and gentlemen. 2 minutes left in the game, and once again, we've got another close game on our hands. That has been the story of the season, every game close, just about. Oh, no, we got hit with the holding call, just run out of bounds. Matt Ryan celebrating. Maybe he's on the defense.
Holding offense.
Nope. It's on us. Ryan Schrader, the right tackle, called with a hold, and that hurts. That definitely hurts, y'all. That definitely hurts.
First down.
But you know what? No time to complain. We just got to get back in it.
The game is closing in on a finish, and the defense can make one play and basically in the game.
Leonard Hankerson, first catch of the game, and it's a first down. That's what we needed to see right there.
The Falcons did a good job that time.
Let's go.
Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs. And
here we go. A minute 35 or so and counting.
This play set up by the long gainer.
Nope. I did not want to throw that one, because that was the same play that we threw the last pick on, and it looked like they had it covered just as well. So I would rather not risk that one right there.
Second down.
Second and 17. A minute 28 left after the timeout here.
Freeman's taking it on the screen.
Oh, Freeman catches it with space and nobody in front. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman with the long touchdown reception, had great blocking on the screen set in front of him, and that's exactly what we needed right there. Looked like Lamar Holmes had a nice little block too to get the one guy that could have made a play. Beautiful play.
The Falcons for the extra point.
Now it's back on the defensive shoulders. 21-17, a minute 19 in the game, and Indy has all three timeouts. This is where we need a big stop. Now, the zone coverage has not been working too well for us in this game, unfortunately. Andrew Luck has been tearing us apart, so we've got to find an answer. The man coverage is okay, but it's not all 100% effective either. Tough hit by Joplo Bartu on the kick return of T.Y. Hilton. First and 10, 1 minute, 16 seconds left in the game. And the way this is right now, this is not going to go to an overtime game.
The make or break moment in this ball game, partner.
This either win or go home right now.
We've seen him in this situation so many times, and I'll say this, most of the time he comes through and gets it done.
Luck out of the gun.
Good play defensively. I didn't see you broke it up. Reed. Nice play by Reed to get in front of that and bat it away.
They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
The Colts have to be hoping this doesn't turn out like last week's game. Tough luck losers a week ago and trailing in another.
Picked! Jalen Collins with the huge interception. That is what we needed right there, ladies and gentlemen. Fifth interception on the year. That is an amazing number to reach. And this is only week 11. We still got five more weeks. Not to mention potential playoffs. Jalen Collins right there, potentially the player of the game. Not really, but with one of the biggest plays. He won't be player of the game because I think that would go to doggone Freeman with the way that he's played in this game. But that was a beautiful play. That's something that we needed right there. See if we can slide to that left side. See if that helps him. Nope. Toy Lolo let his man through, and it just got all in the way. We were still able to gain at least a yard from it, but that was not a pretty play.
That last running play.
Second and nine.
A yard, so it's second down and nine.
And now here's the toss.
Oh, Tevin Coleman getting a nice run, outrunning someone in the backfield, making it a third and 2 yards to gain. We can do this. Third and two here. Some tough running will give us a first down and maybe put this game away. And that should do it, ladies and gentlemen. Indy will call their last timeout, but that is it. Two knees, and this game should be over. What another great game that we've had on the season. So if you haven't been following up with any of my stuff, please, please, please check out the prior videos in the season. They are up on YouTube. I post under the same name as I do on Twitch, Shakir725. And now, too, if you didn't hear at the beginning of the video, I also have a Twitter page, Shakir725, there as well. Feel free to go subscribe. I'll try to keep y'all up to date on what's going on. You know, try to make sure that I let y'all know when I stream, when I post, etc., etc., so that you can get as much of the Falcons franchise here as you want. I try to keep y'all up to date with also the when we get to the off season and everything. I'll make sure to have an episode about that and the draft and everything associated with that too, so you can see what kind of changes I think. If you have anything that you want to suggest, I am open to suggestions as well. You can send me a message on any of the three platforms that I mentioned: Twitch, YouTube, or Twitter, and let me know what you think. If you think there's somebody that I should go after or somebody that I should let go that's already currently on the team, you know, I'd be curious to find out what y'all have to say about that. But another great win here that puts us at 9-1 on the year, another step closer to the playoffs. You know, we've been making a nice run at it. I mean, granted, we didn't expect the Colts to be the toughest of toughest teams, but they were in this game again, a tough team. You know, they made us earn this win. It went down to the wire. We did not walk away with anything. And if you have missed it earlier too, this was on all Madden difficulty, like all my games are. No slider changes. What a wonderful game. Devontae Freeman had a great game in this one here, but a lot of big plays all around.
So for Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.
I definitely appreciate y'all tuning in, though, watching and supporting. You know, it actually encourages me to continue to put more videos out there. If there's other games, too, that y'all want to see me play, please let me know. If I got them, I will play them and let you know that I've played them and broadcasted them and put them up on YouTube and all that good stuff. You know, I've got a pretty good-sized game collection, so chances are I might have the game that you are asking to see played, especially if it's something that you're curious about, not certain whether or not you want to buy. You know, if I've got it, you know, I'll let you know. If I don't have it, I can look into getting it. So thank y'all, though, very much for tuning in. This has been another broadcast of the Falcons franchise. I'll catch y'all next time.